We were talking, of course, about the upcoming telecom policy, and who better to talk about policy matters than a policymaker himself. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together to extend a warm round of applause for the Honorable Minister of State for Communications, Government of India, Shri Manoj Sinha. Sir, if I can kindly request for you to come up here and address the audience.
Mr. Chin, Mr. Arun, members of the Economic Times editorial team, leading lights of the telecom industry, senior officers of the Government of India and our PSUs, invitees from media, ladies and gentlemen. I consider it a matter of privilege and honor to be invited to speak at the inaugural ceremony of the India Mobile Conclave 2018 here today. At the outset, I take the opportunity to thank the organizers of this event, the Times Group, and especially ET Telecom for their efforts to organize an event such as this. Such events provide a unique platform for all stakeholders engaged in telecom sector together, exchange ideas and information, and learn from our collective experiences. The value of an event such as this cannot be overstated, given the dynamic and rapidly changing nature of our industry, which is literally evolving at the speed of thought. Events such as this are of special relevance to our country. Let me share with you some facts and figures which highlights our achievements in this area in the last few years. In the last 3 years, we have added more than 266 million mobile connections and 140 million additional internet connections in the country. We sold approximately 511 megahertz spectrum between 2012 to 14, and more than 2.5 times that number, 1382.25 megahertz between 2015 and 17. Our internet traffic has increased from 561 million GB in April-June 2016 to 2988 million GB only 2 quarters later. In last 3 years, we have installed more than 7 lakh BTS base transceiver stations in order to promote digital coverage, taking our total BTS count to about 14.6 lakhs. We had a meager 5 units manufacturing telecom equipment in the country in 2014. Today we have a staggering 118 such units manufacturing more than 22.50 crores mobile handset annually. Till 2014, we were able to lay 7 lakh kilometers of optical fiber in the country. Now we have 14 lakh kilometers of cable optical fiber in this country. What these numbers highlights is that our government is fully committed to actively enable, facilitate, and support the creation and strengthening of a strong digital infrastructure that will help realize the Digital India dream of our Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi. However, I must also acknowledge that our country's context is rather complex and often paradoxical. We are the second largest consumer of the internet in the world, and yet more than two-thirds of our population is yet to get online. Bridging this digital divide is the key to harnessing the vast growth potential of our country so that we can claim our rightful place in the galaxy of nations. As the saying goes, the petty done, the undone vast. The more we do, the more remains to be done. In our rapidly globalizing world, human aspirations are not and should not be limited by considerations of feasibility and practicality. And I consider this to be an excellent challenge for all of us who are engaged in meeting these aspirations. Academia, policymakers, industry, and regulators. As we assess emerging directions, trends, policies, and technologies, we must think of the last person in the queue and ask ourselves, are these likely to make a difference to his, her existence? It is the face of that last person in the queue that should guide and inspire us as we evolve our industry. In support of our Digital India program, we initiated a project BharatNet to broadband enable our 2.5 lakh gram panchayats in the country by March 2019. It gives me immense pleasure to share with you that in phase one of this project, we have already covered more than 1 lakh gram panchayats by December 2017. In the process, we had led more than 2.6 lakh kilometers of optical fiber cable across the length and breadth of the country. In fact, our average rate of laying cables over the last 18 months has more than 240 kilometers per day. The project remains on track to cover the remaining 1.5 lakh gram panchayats on schedule by March 2019. BharatNet is possibly the largest project of its kind in the world, and the infrastructure it creates will be available for use by all service providers on a non-discriminatory basis. This infrastructure will benefit all sections of our vast and magnificent country through the provision of services such as e-health and e-education. An important point to note is that all equipment and components for the BharatNet projects were indigenously manufactured, thereby providing a boost to our Make in India program. Many of us may know that as a result of the role it played in manufacturing the communication equipment required for its BharatNet project, last month, Indian telephone industry was able to report its first quarter of operating profit in several years. Let me now touch upon the National Telecom Policy 2018 that is currently under development in our ministry. We believe that this policy will be the harbinger of equitable, sustainable, stress-free, and inclusive growth of the telecom sector in our country over the next several years. National Telecom Policy 2018 is expected to focus on a few arching areas, stimulate the market for sustainable growth, promote ubiquitous and inclusive universal access, improve the quality of experience for consumers across the country, facilitate the development of competencies and institutional capacities to deliver results on an ongoing basis, create and support opportunities for entrepreneurship in the sector, support the assessment, refinement, adoption, and deployment of next generation technologies in line with the changing needs of our people, support the government's mission to strengthen the ease of doing businesses. Under the chairmanship of Secretary Telecom, our team in DOT is working on the details and nuances of this policy, which we'll hope to be able to publish for public very soon. I expect specific domains such as licensing framework, research and development, and innovation, and security and privacy to be covered under National Telecom Policy 2018. One of the most important areas for us to explore the assess today is the emerging 5G technology. We have taken steps and are committed to providing budgetary support to help set up a test bed in our country for this purpose at IIT Chennai. We believe this will act as a catalyst in our endeavor to realize our dream of Digital India. At the end, I would like to once again commend the organizers of this event for getting us all together on a common platform. I see from the event schedule that there are several interesting and meaningful sessions planned throughout the day. I am confident that these sessions will help all the participants arrive at considered outputs which can be taken forward for further deliberation and action in the days to come. It is only through such collaboration and cooperation that we can collectively create a better shared future for everyone. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much for that, sir. Thank you so much for talking about the opportunities for India in the communication space, but also the challenges. You've said the more you do, the more there remains to be done. We hope to discuss some of those. Could I kindly request for TK Arun at this point to initiate a brief chat session with our guests on stage. Over to you, Arun.
In order to achieve Digital India, telecom companies, of course, will play the role of providing this service. But in order for these companies to operate properly, the government must empower them and facilitate them. There is a trade-off between seeing telecom companies as enablers of Digital India and as revenue generators. Now, where will the government try to play this trade-off?
पूरे worldwide consolidation इस sector में हो रहा है और मुझे लगता है कि यह देश भी उससे वंचित नहीं है। जब जरूरत पड़ी है सरकार ने इंटरवीन किया है और एक रिस्पांसिबल गवर्नमेंट की तरह आगे भी सरकार इंटरवीन करेगी। अभी हाल ही में इंटर मिनिस्ट्रियल ग्रुप की जो रिकमेंडेशंस थी उसको सरकार ने लागू किया है और मैं समझता हूं कि इस सेक्टर की एक सक्सेसफुल स्टोरी रही है और सरकार पूरी तरह से इसके लिए प्रतिबद्ध है कि टेलीकॉम सर्विस प्रोवाइडर्स की वो सक्सेसफुल स्टोरी आगे भी बनी रहे। दूसरी बात, जहां तक टेलीकॉम पॉलिसी का सवाल है, तो केवल वो मैंने इस पर विशेष सरकार ध्यान दे रही है, केवल रेवेन्यू जनरेशन का वो माध्यम न रहे बल्कि एक फैसिलिटेटर की भूमिका में टेलीकॉम पॉलिसी हो, ताकि देश में जो डिजिटल डिवाइड है वो खत्म हो सके और देश के अंतिम आदमी को भी डिजिटल सेवाएं हम दे सके।
योर कंपनी हैज बीन इनोवेटिंग 5G टेक्नोलॉजीज एंड यू आर द लोवेस्ट कॉस्ट इक्विपमेंट सप्लायर्स इन मेनी पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड, एक्चुअली अराउंड द वर्ल्ड। येट रिसेंटली इन द US द सिक्योरिटी एजेंसीज कंसर्न्ड एक्सप्रेस सम रिजर्वेशंस about using Huawei equipment on security grounds. What is your response?
I would like to give you some information. Currently, more and more customers complain Huawei is not low-cost company now. So regarding the product is called Stop in the US, which is the handset Mi 10. This model handset actually is commercialized in the European market almost half a year earlier than in the US. And it is well welcomed by the European market, almost, and also partnershiped with more than 170 countries with the operators in these countries. So in the US, we really believe it is a true loss for the US public, and of course, also for Huawei. This product possible in India, a few people tried, because it's not commercialized in Indian market. But I believe it is the best model of the handset for many features, such as one feature for the camera. All the people believe it is the best camera of the handsets. So currently, from my side, what I would like to share is, I don't understand what happened in the US market, but it is loss for the US public and also for Huawei for this such a good product. And we believe time will tell us. Thank you.
Given that even aluminum and steel now face huge tariffs in the US on the ground of national security, it's not surprising that national security has been deployed to defend handset market also. Sir, while speaking, you said the policy will take into account the concerns of privacy and data security. Now, data security, Europe will actually begin their tough implementation of data security from May. And they have this condition that for a European data to be transferred to another jurisdiction, it must correspond to the standards they themselves deploy in European countries. How soon will be able to come out with a data protection law? And will they be of the same standards as in Europe?
मुझे लगता है कि चाहे वॉयस हो चाहे डेटा हो दोनों की सिक्योरिटी हमारी टॉप प्रायोरिटी है और दुनिया भर में जो वर्ल्ड में बेस्ट ग्लोबल प्रैक्टिसेस हैं उनको हम फॉलो करें नेशनल टेलीकॉम पॉलिसी में इसका विशेष हम ध्यान भी रखेंगे और जस्टिस अय्यर की जो समिति है मुझे लगता है कि दो महीने में डेटा को लेकर के जो कानून बना रही है उससे भी इस देश को पूरी तरह सुरक्षित हम कर पाएंगे
नाउ इंडिया एज अ कंट्री स्पेंड्स लेस देन 2% ऑफ जीडीपी ऑन आरएनडी चाइना स्पेंड्स कोरिया स्पेंड्स 3% और 4% चाइना स्पेंड्स क्लोज टू 3% Huawei एज अ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इनोवेटिव कंपनीज हाउ मच डू स्पेंड ऑन आरएनडी
Every year, the more than 10% of the revenue were put into the R&D.
10% of revenue?
Yes.
Sir, how do you see telecom playing a role in financial inclusion?
मुझे लगता है कि टेलीकॉम सेक्टर का रोल फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन में बहुत ज़्यादा है और भारत नेट की जो प्रोजेक्ट अभी हम पूरा कर रहे हैं 1,00,000 ग्राम पंचायतों तक हम गए हैं और जैसा मैंने अभी बताया कि जो शेष 1.5 लाख ग्राम पंचायतें हैं वहाँ तक 19 मार्च तक पहुँच जाएंगे तो ये फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन में काफ़ी हद तक मदद करने वाला है इसके अलावा भी लक्षद्वीप हो अंडमान निकोबार आइलैंड हो वहाँ भी कनेक्टिविटी की परियोजनाएँ हमने प्रारंभ की हैं नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न स्टेट्स के लिए कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव टेलीकॉम प्लान हमने बनाया हुआ था जो काम हमारा शुरू हो गया है वाईफाई हॉटस्पॉट्स बीएसएनएल 25,000 एक्सचेंजेज में हम लगा रहे हैं कॉमन सर्विस सेंटर्स जो हैं उनके माध्यम से 5,000 वाईफाई चौपाल का काम हम कर रहे हैं तो अनेक मैं कहूँ कि इनिशिएटिव्स सरकार ने लिए हैं और ये निश्चित रूप से फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन में लोगों की मदद करने वाला है
योर कंपनी जियो हैज प्लेड अ बिग रोल इन इंप्रूविंग इंडियाज डेटा कनेक्टिविटी एंड डेटा कंजम्पशन एंड दैट फिट्स इन वेल विद द नेशनल पॉलिसी ऑफ क्रिएटिंग अ डिजिटल इंडिया बट क्रिएटिंग अ डेटा फ्रेमवर्क इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम क्रिएटिंग यूजफुल कंटेंट While the government has various government governance-related services lined up to be consumed, the amount of data that will be consumed through this is quite small. Unless we have vast infrastructure for education, healthcare, and other commercial opportunities which will be facilitated through this data connectivity, we will remain underutilizing this network. What are the plans that we should have for making full use of our capacity in connectivity?
I'm glad you mentioned that. A couple of things. First of all, it is not right to say that we are not using connectivity. 18 months ago, we were 100 megabytes. Now, average across Jio that we have publicly said is over 12 GB per user. However, I agree with you. The full potential of connectivity to be leveraged requires what I call as a comprehensive national digital and national telecom policy. They cannot be separate. It has to be comprehensive across domains. Why do I say it has to be across domains? Because it's no longer a data sector, voice sector. It's an everything converged and everything interconnected in a connected intelligence world. So it is extremely important that we create pillars of innovation and pillars of inclusive empowerment across domains. So it is not just about content per se, but like you said, digitization across agriculture, healthcare, transportation, energy, etc. But it's got to be a digital and telecom policy that's going to enable that together.
Thank you, Zuman. Thank you, sir. We already detained you a little beyond the time you had granted us. We'll be right back.